हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू जावा ट्यूटोरियल्स। टॉपिक्स फॉर टुडे सेशन इज, टुडे वी लर्न अबाउट द मेथड ओवरराइडिंग, रूल्स फॉर मेथड ओवरराइडिंग एंड द डिफरेंस बिटवीन द मेथड ओवरलोडिंग एंड मेथड ओवरराइड। मेथड ओवरराइडिंग इज डिक्लेयरिंग द मेथड इन सब क्लास, दैट इज इन द चाइल्ड क्लास, which is already present in the parent class is known as the method overriding. That is, when we are performing the inheritance, okay, when we are doing implementing the method overriding, there must be the easy relationship. That means it must be the inheritance between the two or more classes. Okay, overriding is done, the child class gives its own implementation which already provided by the parent class. Okay, what is the meaning of this? The parent class has the some method which is again defining in the child class is called the method overriding. In this type of case, method in the parent class is called the overridden method and method in the child class is called the overriding method. So when we are implementing the method overriding, child class can give its own implementation or it uses the its overridden method, that is in the parent class method. The use of the method overriding is, it is used for the runtime polymorphism, and the advantage of this is the class can gives its own specific implementation to a inherited method without modifying the parent class code. The code which is described in the parent class cannot be modified, but implementing in the inherited method in the child class is called the method overriding. Okay, the rules for method overriding is, the rule for the first rule is that the method must have the same name as in the parent class. When we are implementing the overriding, the same name must be in the child class which is already defined in the parent class, and the method must have the same parameter as in the parent class. The arguments or parameters must be the same number and same types must be in the parent class and child class, and there must be the easy relationship. Easy relationship means inheritance between the two classes, and private, static and final methods cannot be overridden because these are the local. Private members means private members are private for that block or that class only. Static means that is the common for the all objects. Final means those are the final which can be are used to create the no need to implement the overloading. For that, these are the local for that class, so we cannot override these methods. And constructors cannot be overridden. Means parent can have its own constructors and subclass or child class can have its own. But constructor means constructor is the same name as the class name. So parent class name is different from child class name. So constructors cannot be overridden. These are the rules to be followed when we are implementing the method overriding. And this is the example for the method overriding. Here we define the one program that which has the animal class, which is the display method, which doesn't have any parameters, and its return type is the void, and this method is the public type. Means this can be used in subclass as well as in the same package of the other classes. Okay, here it displaying the just the print statement, that is I am an animal, and this class is called only one method. And here we are defining the subclass, that is the dog, which is extended to the animal. Means a dog class is the subclass for the animal class, means the child class. Here we are again display using the display method, which must be the same name. It is called the overriding method. Which method is overriding? Display method of the pair. This is the overridden method and this is the overriding method. This also the void, and it here also it must be the void, and it also has the one print statement, that is I am a dog, and the class is closed. What is the meaning of that? This method is overridden by the child class's same method, display method. When we are creating the object in the main method, that is the D1, for the child class only we can create the objects. For dog class, we are defining the object D1. So D1.display, which method is invoked? It invokes its own method, that is the display method. Actually, what is the meaning of inheritance? The child class can access the members of the parent class, means this display method can be accessed here, but here it is overridden, means this statement is overridden by this, so it displays only this. To overcome this, we can use the super keyword in the child class. This is the use of the super keyword. What is the use of super? Super can be used in three different situations. That is, super can be used to access the overridden fields. Super can also be used for access the overridden methods. And also for the constructor of the parent class. Here to access the method of super class, from the subclass, we use the super keyword. How we can use it? You see in this. The same program which is in the previous slide is animal is the parent class and dog is the child class. Here we are displaying, display method is displayed, and again here also we are using the display. So here display method is overridden. But the only difference is here we are using the super. Super dot method name can be used to override the method of the parent class. Okay, here it displays. Sorry, here you have to write the display. This is the wrong info. Super dot display, and always the this must be the first statement in the, when we are using the super, that super keywords statement must be the first statement. So this display method is overriding method, and this is the overridden method of the parent class. So the super dot display, it invokes the parent class method. When we are creating the object for the dog D1.display, it invokes this method. But what is the statement here? Super dot display. So this statement invokes this. What it displays? It displays I am an animal. So first this print statement is invoked, and after that we have the I am a dog. So these two statements are executed. Like this, parent class method and as well as the child class method is invoked or executed. And this is the another method which named as the AB, which is the parent class which has the method. What we call the parent method is called the overridden method. And the child class, that is the demo, which is extended by the parent class AB. Okay, here it is the super parent class method. We are accessing by using super. What is the method name? My method. So it invokes this method. And what is it displaying? Overriding method. Overriding means which is defined with the same name as in the parent class, and same parameters, same types are called as the overriding method. Which method is in the parent class is called the overridden method. Here we defined the object for the child class, demo object, and new demo. Here obj.object.my method, it invokes this method, and it is invoking this. So this statement, the print statement in the parent class as well as the print statement in the child class, can be executed. The output is displayed like this. And this is the another method which is the which is for the implementing the overriding, that is the vehicle class. Vehicle class. Which has the class, which has the one method, that is the run method, which is having the print statement and return type is the void. Okay, here we are defining the class bike which is extended by the vehicle class. So vehicle class is the parent class for the bike. We are overriding the method run method. So this is the overridden method and this is the overriding. Here it is displaying the vehicle is running and this is displaying bike is running safely print step. When we are creating the object for the subclass, that is the bike class, okay, with the help of bike class, the object of this object can be created with the help of new operator, and we can call the method with the help of object. We are calling the method obj, that is the object name, dot run. Run is the method of the subclass or child class, so it invokes this method. Okay, what is it? It displayed what is what it has. It has the print statement bike is running safely. So the parent class method is overridden by the child class method run. Okay, so this statement is not. If you want to execute this, you have to write the super dot run of the parent class method. So when we are using the super, it executes the its parent class same method. Okay, here we didn't use the super, so it invokes only its own method. Okay, this is the method overriding, and this is the access specifiers. Which access specifiers can be used when we are implementing the method overriding? Okay, the same method declared in the super class and its subclass can have the different access specifier, but access specifiers must be in the subclass can have the larger access which is compared to the access specifiers in the super class. That is called, that is, for example, here you observe, here we have the class animal which have the show method which is defined as the void which doesn't return any value to the calling statement, and its access specifier is the protected. So when we are overriding this method within its child class, here we define the child class dog as the child for the animal class. But here we are overriding the show method. When we are overriding that, the access specifier must be the equal to the protected as it is in the parent class, or larger access than the parent class. That is, it may be the public or protected, not the private. Private is the smaller access compared to the protected. So we have defined as the public and it displaying the I am a dog. And when we are creating the object for the child class in the main method, we only create the objects within its main class only. Okay, dog object is the d1 dot show. It invokes the child class method, that is the show method of the dog. So it invoked, and what is its implementation? It has the only one print statement, that is the I am a dog. It invokes. The parent class method is overridden by the child class. Okay, here you have to observe that what are the access specifiers used. The protected access specifier is used in the parent class. That must be, when we are overriding this same method, that must be the same access specifier or the larger access than this access specifier must be specified when we are overriding this method in the child class. So here we have to use the, either you have to use the protected as well as the public. So we are, you defined this as the public in the child class. And the differences between the method overloading and method overriding is, method overloading, what is the meaning of method overloading? Method overloading is the one of the concept of the polymorphism which has the different within the same class we can implement the method overloading, but in the method overriding we have the two different classes. Okay, and here you observe the differences. Method overloading is used to increase the readability of the program. Method overloading means the same method with different arguments with different data types can be defined within the same method is called the method overloading. The same method which is defined in the parent class again defined in the child class is called the method overriding. Okay, the same, the difference is it increase the readability, and it method overriding specifies the specific implementation of the method that is defined in the super or parent class is called the method overriding. Okay, this is performed within the class only, and this is performed when the two classes have the easy relationship, means when we have the implementing the inheritance, then only it is possible to implement the overriding. But for the overloading, we have to perform within the same class. Okay, the parameters must be different in the overloading. The parameter must be the same as like in the parent and child class is the same as the parent class. That is the difference. And this is the example for the compile time polymorphism. And this is for example for the runtime polymorphism. It invokes when we are executing. Okay, and this is the, it has the return type must say can be same or different in method overloading, but return type must be the same type in the method overriding. Okay, but we must have the change the parameters. Okay, the possibility for the same or different for the method overloading in the return type policy, but in the overriding it must be the same. The starting methods cannot be overloaded. If we define the static method methods, that cannot be overloaded. We cannot define multiple times the same method, because static means common to all objects. Means once we define, that can be the common for the all objects. We cannot overload the static methods. But here, it can be overloaded. And the here static methods cannot be overridden, because what is the meaning of overridden? Again implementing in the child class. So static method once defined in the parent class, that cannot be overridden. Means child can share the methods of the parent. No need to implement again in the child class. So we cannot override the static methods. But here static method can be overloaded, and private and final methods can be overloaded. Private, because within the class only we are implementing the overloading, but private and final methods cannot be overridden, because overridden is done in two different classes. One is the parent and again other is the child. Private means private is the private for that class only. Only within that class only we can use those members. A child class means other than the class. After closing that class, we can define the child class. So private members cannot be accessed outside the class. So private methods cannot be overridden. Final methods also. Final means final for that. Those methods cannot be overridden to the overridden in the child class. So private and final methods can be overloaded, because within the same class overloading is defined. So these can be overloaded in the overloaded, but these are the method overloading is different relation between the two different classes. So these cannot be implemented in the overriding. So private and final methods cannot be overridden. And this is the example for the overriding and overloading. Overloading, you observe that overloading means we define the class dog, and here we have the method public void bark, and it has the one print statement. Okay, overloading means same method name, different parameters or different return types within the same class, if we define, that is called the overloading. Again, we define the bark. This is the different. It has no parameters, but it has the one parameter, that is the integer. So now this bark method is overloading. Okay. What it is, its implementation is no problem. But here we have to observe that same method name again defined in the same class. Here class method closed and class closed. Overloading means two different classes. One is the parent and another is the child. Here we have the dog class which has the method bark. it has some print statement. And again we have, if the class is closed and we are defining the child class, that is the hound, which is extended by the dog. So dog class, hound class is the child class for the dog. Here we have defining the method. It has the its own method, and here we define the bark method, which is the overridden method. So here what is the method? Same written type, public and void. Void, it has no parameters, and it must also has the no parameters. But here you observe it is the no parameter, and it is the same class. Within the class only we are defining. This is the one class and this is the another class. This is the different you have to observe in the overriding and overloading. Okay. And this is the again exam implementation of this. This is the overriding, same class with different parameters. Here is the method, three times we are defining. It has the only one parameter. Here we have the two parameters. Here we have the three parameters. It is called the method overloading. Within the same class, we can define the method with different parameters or different data types is called the overloading. But here is the overriding. Here we have the base class or parent class or super class is called the base class, parent class, which has the method, which has the only one parameter, that is the X. And with the derived class or child class or subclass is called the child class, which is derived from the base class, which is the same method. Here we have the method and one argument, that is the X. Here you have to also define the same name and same arguments, that is called the method overriding. This is the difference between the overloading and overriding. This is within the same class, and here we have the two classes, and that must be the easy relationship, means inheritance. When we have the inheritance process, then only we can implement the overriding. Within the same class only overloading is possible. This is the difference between the overloading and overriding. And in the summary, in this lesson, you learn method overriding. Method overriding means implementing the method which is in the subclass already defined in the parent class is called the method overriding. The rules to be followed. The same class same name must be specified, and same type of parameters, same number of parameters must be followed in the child class. And constructors cannot be overridden. Okay. And the final, private, final and starting methods cannot be overridden. When we are using the specifying the access specifiers, the parent class access specifier and child class access specifier must be the same, or child class access specifier must be the larger access than the parent class specifier. These rules have to be followed when we are implementing the overriding. That is, in the child class, when we are implementing the same method with the same name in the parent class, we have to follow these rules. And different examples we learn in this method. And again in the last we learn about the method overloading and method overriding. Method overloading means overloading the same method within the same class. Means within the class, different methods with the same name, different in the return type, number of arguments or data types is defined is called the overloading. And method overloading is the when it is implemented in the two or more classes when they have the easy relationship, that is the inheritance process only we can implement the overriding. Parent class method can also be again defined or implemented in the child class with the same name is called the overriding. And thank you one and all.